chakra, next chakra is Vishuddhi. Vishuddhi is centered in the throat. Vishuddhi. Vishuddhi. Of course, there are many pronunciations in Pali. There are three types of Sanskrit. Here is Vedic Sanskrit and modern Sanskrit. So, Vishuddhi we call it in modern Sanskrit. You see, just what are the main aspects, main important subjects which affects our life? Money, something. Then, not that time, that time. Money, health, name and fame, beauty, anything else? That's what, money. So, you know what I call money? Intellect. Money, intellect, power. Power means the name and fame, or power qualities. Power. And that's what status, the power word itself denotes the status. Beauty, achievement. What is the one you No, not that kind of thing.
Education.
Education. Vidya, that's what I call jnana. So, all these things you see, can anyone claim that I am the rich man? Comparison. Can anyone claim I am the beautiful person?
Which one is richer? When you see
if you see the photographs of the so-called beautiful persons in the newspapers, you will not feel like second time seeing. Second time looking, then you will into. Am I right? You will find many times. You will just turn the next page and go for reading some other news. Yes, you can say, even this may experience. When you see that some so-called looking good people, there are so many photographs, some competition, all these things. You will not feel like looking second time, just turn and read some other news. So, there are two types of reality. Existential reality, comparative reality. Comparative reality means, now you are rich. You think you are rich. But can you claim that you are rich? No. So this is not existential reality, this is comparative reality, which is not existing. Yes, you can all listen. The same way, about beauty. Can you claim that you are the beautiful, beautiful person? Can you claim you are not the beautiful person? Can you claim you are the beautiful person? Can you claim you are not the beautiful person? No, there will be somebody who is uglier than you. Comparison. The whole thing is comparative reality, which is not existing. In Vedanta, beautifully called Maya, which is not existing but continuously disturbing. This is the definition for Maya. Yama iti Maya. It is not there, but it is there.
That is called illusion.
Illusion. You see, can you say you are the rich person? Can you say you are the poor person? Both cannot be told. Both is not true. But some itching will be there always inside. Both cannot be told. But both are true. But that is the greatest hindrance for enlightenment. That is the greatest hindrance for self-realization. That is the greatest hindrance. That is the greatest disturbance for joyful life to attain the Sachidananda. You understand? Yama iti maya. It is not there, but it is there. Do you say that I am the most powerful person in the whole state? No. Do you say that I have no power at all? No. The fluid reality is called comparative reality. All our life, all our disturbance, all our depression, all our problems is based on this comparative reality. If you look at this side, the things which you have, make a big list, you can make a big list, starting from a pen, notebook, space, house, car, so many things you can make a big list. And this side, you make a big list, which you don't have. You can make a big list, Rolls Royce car, helicopter, aeroplane, you can make a big list, which you don't have. This side also infinite things are there which you don't have. This side also infinite things are there which you have. It is up to you to decide whether to look this side and be happy or whether to look this side and be unhappy. What do you mean? What do you understand? You understand? Selection. It is up to you whether to be happy or unhappy, whether to be ananda or in dukkha. Now I am giving a key to you, please be very clear.
Better not to see both the sides.
That is the only beautiful life. Better not to see both the sides. If you are able to be, if you are able to live without looking at both sides, you can, I think you are able to. It is utterly impossible to live without looking both the sides. No. Unless you will be continuously looking at one side or the if you are getting enlightened, if you are becoming enlightened.
But we will be seeing, but better not to.
Yes, you can do one thing. You can see, but you don't have to take in. You can be without getting that affected, without getting affected. That is the key to unlock this chakra. So this side, if you see, if all the people are made to stand in a queue according to their economical status, you will find an infinite number of persons this side who are richer than you. This side you will find infinite number of persons who are poorer than you. It is up to you to look this side and happy. Or to look this side and be sad. These words are all already used traditionally and given so many meanings which I don't want to use. The words which I am using, you can see some real sharpness. Happiness is a choice. You see, I am telling you, it is up to you whether to be happy or to be sad. You may, what you are asking, happiness is a choice. It's true. Ananda is the reality. Happiness is not a reality, it's a choice. But from happiness, you can jump into ananda. From dukkha, you cannot jump into ananda. In dukkha, you will be caught with the world. You will be fighting with the shadow. But when you are satisfied, when you are contented, you can enter into the world of ananda. Ananda leads to ananda. Dukkha never leads to ananda. Okay. So it is up to you to decide whether to be comparative, whether to be jealousy, or to be contented, to be happy. Whether to lock the chakra or open the chakra, it is up to you. To unlock this chakra, you don't have to go to any forest and do tapasya. The so-called old Vedantists always advise, go and sit in a forest, do some tapasya, do some hard tapasya, go for these chakras. I say there is no need. You can in your house, in your life. See, decide whether to look this side or this side, that's enough. To open this chakra, you will be out of Maya, you will be a Maya Tita. Can go beyond the Maya when you see very clearly. Side to look. So this chakra is locked out of jealousy, this chakra is open. When you feel that I don't want to bother with somebody else, I will live my life. I will fulfill my desires. I will fulfill my life. Most of us, there are many people who question. Swamiji, you say God is so mercy. God is full of mercy. God is loving us. But we feel our life is filled with discontentment. We don't get this. You say that God is everything. But in practical life, we see God is there not doing anything. We are only needing discontentment. The explanation, the answer for this question is, God always gives what we want, exactly. Only God doesn't give the desires which we acquire from the next man, from neighbor. If you are saving money to purchase a TV, TV costs 10,000, you have saved more than 9,000. But suddenly, the opposite man, house man, or a neighbor brings a fridge into his house. Immediately your wife will say, I don't want TV, I want fridge, immediately listen. You bring the fridge. Can you see that neighbor is, how your neighbor is feeling? You start comparing, you start having some jealousy. Then we acquire their desires in our life. We take their desires and try to work out in our life. We don't get the things which is others' desires. You always get what you are working. And according to me, according from my experience, I say, God never even sees about the world. He simply showers on us what we need. That is the truth. Existence simply showers on you. Only we people are so well versed, so trained in the discipline of discontentment. We are so trained, so well trained. Even if you get one Rolls Royce immediately as a gift, before sitting, entering into the Rolls Royce, you will start remembering about some other big car. You will start thinking about some other big items. We are so well versed with the training, in the mindset of the discontentment.
Desire.
Discontentment. We always feel we want to live in a discontentment. And before getting anything, even if it's a small thing, you will feel as if there is a hill equal to hill. Without that, your life will not move. You will feel that as if it's a big mountain. But after getting the thing, even if you get the mountain, you will feel it is something like that. You will not even remember that you will lie down in your house, in your car. If somebody asks, where is that thing? Yes, it is lying down, it may be lying down somewhere. I don't search, let me search and give you. That is the way in which the mind works. Generally, the Ramaji says, in Tamil, I'll tell you in Tamil, someone can answer. அடைவதற்கு முன் கடுகே ஆனாலும் மலையாய் காட்டி அடைந்த பின் மலையே ஆனாலும் கடுகாய் காட்டு மாயமான
after you attain the mountain also,
it becomes
as simple as a mustard.
Mustard. The mustard becomes mountain, and mountain becomes mustard before and after getting that thing. This is the way the Srisuddhi chakra gets locked. To unlock the chakra is to be content, to be happy, just to live with your desires, live with your ideas, live with your individuality. Not to bring their desires and work out your life. God has given them in Jainism, there is a beautiful concept. Anybody Jains? In Jainism there is a beautiful concept. When God sends you to this earth, He sends the food quantity. How much you will take to grow your life, it will be sent to the world. The whole quantity can be sent to the world. In the same way, it is true. I say you, when God sends you to this earth, He sends whatever your desires along with you. But when you come and descend, when you come and land on this earth, immediately you start having new desires from them, from others. So that is the thing where the problem starts. That is not the thing, don't have desires, but have your desires. Don't have their desires. The meditation on conscious analysis of desire will very clearly picture, will give you a clear picture what is your desire and what is others' desire. What you have taken from your heart, what you have taken from others' head, it will be very clearly shown to you by meditation on conscious analysis.